In this video, we will talk about adrenergic receptors. As per the name adrenergic receptors, they are involved in mediating response to the adrenergic system, that is the sympathetic nervous system. A common feature shared across all adrenergic receptors is that they all are G-protein-coupled receptors. Now let's talk about the types of adrenergic receptors. Broadly, the receptors are categorized into alpha adrenergic receptors and beta adrenergic receptors. Let's first go into the alpha receptors. There are two subtypes of alpha adrenergic receptors: alpha 1 and alpha 2. Talking about the details of alpha 1 receptors, they are GQ protein coupled. That means they activate the IP3-DAG pathway of intracellular signaling. As they are GQ coupled, they usually cause a stimulatory effect on the cell. Now let's see their distribution and what effects they produce when stimulated. They are found in blood vessels, where they cause vasoconstriction. They are also seen in certain smooth muscles in the genitourinary tract, where they cause contraction, like contraction of trigone muscles, which opposes the voiding of the bladder, and rhythmic contraction of vas deferens and seminal vesicle, which contribute to ejaculation. They are also found in glands, where they cause secretion. And finally, they are also found in the guts, where they cause relaxation. An example of a selective agonist for the alpha 1 receptor is phenylephrine. And a selective antagonist is prazosine. So this was the alpha 1 receptor. Now let's talk about alpha 2 receptors. They are coupled to GIGO proteins. Thus, they act through the adenylyl cyclase CMP pathway. As they are GI protein coupled, we can predict that they usually produce an inhibitory effect. On that note, let's see the distribution of alpha 2 receptors. They are mainly seen in the prejunctional membrane, at the nerve ending. Here they regulate the transmitter release, the exact role being inhibition of release. They are also found in certain areas of the brain. The effect is decreased sympathetic flow. Then, they are also found in pancreatic beta cells. Their stimulation inhibits the release of insulin. Next are platelets. Here they play a role in platelet aggregation. And finally, they are also seen in certain blood vessels, where they cause vasoconstriction. Alpha 2 selective agonist includes clonidine, and the selective antagonist is yohimbine. So these were individual subtypes of alpha receptors. An example of a non-selective agonist that acts on both subtypes of alpha receptors is adrenaline. And non-selective antagonist is phentolamine. So this was all about alpha adrenergic receptors. Now let's move toward the beta receptors. They all are coupled to GS protein. So they act through the adenylyl cyclase CMP pathway. There are three subtypes of beta adrenergic receptors. They are, as you guessed it, beta 1, beta 2, and beta 3. Let's first see beta 1. They are very famous for being present in the heart. Here, in the SA node, they increase rhythmicity. So heart rate is increased. In the AV node and conductive pathway, they increase conduction velocity. In ventricular myocytes, they increase contractility, so the force of contraction is increased. Then they are also found on juxtaglomerular cells in the kidney. Stimulation of these receptors causes renin release. Selective beta 1 agonist includes dobutamine. And selective beta 1 antagonists include metoprolol and atenolol. So that was our beloved beta 1 receptor. Now, beta 2 receptor. They are found in the smooth muscles of so many organs and cause relaxation. In bronchial smooth muscles, they cause bronchodilatation. In blood vessels, they cause vasodilatation. In the uterus, they cause relaxation. In GIT, yes, they cause relaxation. In the pancreas, they cause glucagon secretion. In detrusor muscles, they cause relaxation. And finally, the beta 2 receptors in the ciliary epithelium increase aqueous secretion. Selective beta 2 agonists include salbutamol, terbutaline, etc. And selective antagonist is alpha methyl propranolol. So this was the beta 2 receptor. Now let's talk about beta 3 receptors. They are found in adipose tissues. They are also found in the detrusor muscle, where they cause relaxation. Its selective agonist is mirabegron. So this was the beta 3 receptor. The non-selective agonist for all beta receptors is isoprenoline. And an example of a non-selective antagonist is propranolol. That's all about adrenergic receptors. Now let's have a quick summary. Adrenergic receptors are G-protein-coupled receptors. Broadly, they are divided into alpha and beta adrenergic receptors. Alpha 1 receptors are involved in vasoconstriction, contraction of smooth muscles in the genitourinary tract, glandular secretion, and gut relaxation. Alpha 2 receptors are involved in the inhibition of neurotransmitter release from nerve endings, decrease in sympathetic outflow, inhibition of insulin release, platelet aggregation, and vasoconstriction. Beta 1 receptors are involved in the stimulation of heart activity and the release of renin from JG cells in the kidney. Beta 2 receptors cause bronchoconstriction, vasodilatation, uterine relaxation, relaxation of the digestive tract, detrusor relaxation, and increased aqueous secretion. That's it for this video. You can find notes and explore our entire animation video library at our website. The links are in the description. If you find our content useful, please share it with your friends and colleagues too. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.